Good evening, everyone. Let's to start the next topic on the detection of the hidden explosives. So in this topic, we have to discuss about the explosives and how you identify the hidden explosives. So mostly hidden explosives are those explosives which is carried from by using the various sources such as baskets, then carry bags, then various carriers which are used for to hide the particular explosives at the airport, then public places, then trains, etc. So these explosives has to be identified and has to be detected by using various methods which are being implemented in various countries. So then let's start the what are the methods which are currently using for the detection of the hidden explosives. So mostly hidden explosives detection is to be important in the mostly aeroplanes, then buildings, various government buildings, then suicide bombers attacking crowds, people, busy buses. So these are the places where the hidden explosives identification is very important for the security of the persons or security of the any public. So that's you have to identify. So naturally the primary concern is the detection of the explosives being secreted into an aircraft. Many of the technology has to be developed for these purposes. So in that all the scenarios we have to mention that the every airport and every system we have to use the X-ray systems for the identification of the hidden explosives. So in that case we have to take one by one methods we are currently using for the identification of the hidden explosives. So first method is to be X-ray systems. Yeah, it's very important and it is currently using various places for the identification of the hidden explosives. So in that method, so we have using the X-ray systems for the identification of the hidden explosives. So in that methods, we only how to identify it. So X-ray, you know, the X-ray is having the high intensity radiations which is to be transferred to the particular object, particular carrier. So in that, so various objects are present in a particular bag. So those objects has a density which is having the larger than the other ones. So they are showing in a darker sides. And those luggage carry those objects have very light, so that X-ray is easily passed on that particular material. So they are showing a very light appearance. So it's also when X-ray is passing to a particular hard subject, so it's showing very reflected, it's not transferred. So that object, that particular material is showing in a detail having the darker sides. So in that case, the batteries which has to be coated by the metal, that's why that object is showing the darker sides. Then soaps has having the various soaps is having the very dense material. So that's also showing the very darker sides. So medicines, etc. And this is one of the TNT, intense trinitrotoluene, which has been having the dense materials. So every X-ray systems is having the giving the important information which material is the lighter, which material have denser. So if that particular material is having the dense, so it is possible it is having some explosive materials which is present in the inside particular material. So that cases we have to again verify it from the using its manual using to identify which are present in the inside the particular bags. So this is one of the X-ray system which is mostly using for to identify locate the hidden explosives in the luggage or any particular in methods. So next is one of the computer tomography is also one methods is using for the identification of the hidden explosives. So in that matter, what is the difference between the X-ray and what is the difference between X-ray and computer tomography? So is a simple X-ray is to be one direction is going to X-ray is transferred to the particular objects. So another opposite side having the X-ray detectors. So that rays is to be identified. So in computer tomography having the two systems. One is to be a simple X-ray which is to be already discussed about the simple X-ray. Or second one is a slice plane. So what is slice plane is Muslim? If the object is having the present inside the bag, is having a dense. So second system is to be a cut, and is to be identify key what is inside the particular objects. So that is the second system which is important for the identification of the hidden explosives. So first system is to be identify the what are the dense materials which is present in the particular bag. Or second system is important to cut that particular dense objects and look at the inside the what is inside the particular material. So that is called as a slice place. So slice place required the two systems. One is to be a always be perpendicular angles, and another second system is in the various angles which taking the images of the particular object. So is to create the slice place. So that is called as a computed tomography for identification of the hidden explosives. So this is the image of the computed tomography. So the first system is to be identify the various dense objects which is present in the particular bag. So second is to be having the particular dense. So that particular is to be slicing the particular objects. So means with the particular object is to be taken the angle of the various angles, and then slicing the particular angle. So we have to find the inside the what is inside the particular material. So find that the TNT is inside particular. So that is the second system. So computer tomography is one of the important tools for the identify the hidden explosives. So next is a always you dog. Dog is one of the using for the identification of the hidden explosives. So in enforcement agencies or police agencies using the dogs for the identification of the explosives. So mostly the German Shepherds, and the another one is to be a another one is then German Shepherd, Belgian Morning. This is the breed of the particular dogs which is which is used for the identification of the hidden explosives. So dogs has various rigorous trainings to identify the explosives. In the trainings, so various explosives vapors is to be a and is used for to train the particular dogs and the fresh airs. So after the training, so they are using for the identification of the explosives. So dog is one of the method used for to be an identification of the hidden explosives. The next one is trace detecting. Trace detection means is having the explosives in little quantities. So in that case, we have to be using the various methods, having the digital methods. So in digital methods, we have the Thermobedics is one of the company which is developing the EGGI is a system for the identification of the trace detection. Aaron Barringer is one of the also is one of the digital techniques which is to be important for the identification of the trace detections. So in the currently these are the methods which is mostly used for to identify the hidden explosives. Thank you.